In the lesson on catalysis, we noted that acids make molecules more electrophilic, while bases make molecules more nucleophilic. Enzymes have the ability to orient acids and bases very close to one another, and as a result, they can simultaneously render one substrate more electrophilic and one substrate nearby more nucleophilic, making the coupling of the electrophile and the nucleophile that much more favorable. That's the idea behind bifunctional catalysis, which always involves some kind of synchronous protonation and deprotonation event. Rather than rely on the generation of rather unstable intermediates like enolates or protonated carbonyls, enzymes prefer the smallest energy changes possible. This prevents decomposition of their backbones through stray reactivity of high-energy intermediates. And it's one reason why bifunctional catalysis is so common. By making the timing of protonation and coupling events simultaneous, bifunctional catalysis facilitates chemical reactions with a minimal change in energy. Ketosteroid isomerase is a great example of bifunctional catalysis in action. The enzyme catalyzes the transfer of a proton from the alpha position of this ketosteroid to the gamma position. And while you can imagine this occurring by deprotonation at the alpha position followed by reprotonation gamma, this would involve the production of a rather high-energy enolate intermediate. Instead of producing that intermediate, bifunctional catalysis makes the alpha position more acidic and facilitates removal of the alpha proton. In this way, an enol rather than an enolate is formed. Being neutral, the energy of the enol is much more mild, and although it's not as good of a nucleophile as the enolate, we can now take advantage of a ping-pong effect in which the new nucleophile, close to a decent acid in the enol, facilitates reprotonation at the gamma position of the enol. Even though the end game of this process was the transfer of a proton from the alpha to the gamma position, we can see how protonation and deprotonation rendered parts of the ketosteroid substrate more nucleophilic and more electrophilic through protonation and deprotonation. You'll see this theme come back again and again in problems involving bifunctional catalysis. Unsurprisingly, it's the amino acids with acidic or basic side chains that are very often found as the players in bifunctional catalysis. This slide shows you some representative pKa values for a few side chains, but what you should realize is that the pKa's of side chains in proteins can vary enormously, and these values aren't set in stone. Effective enzymes are able to achieve very specific and precise pKa values in their catalytically active side chains. They need this property in order to selectively and quickly react with only very particular substrates. Enzymes have the ability to modulate pKa by changing the electrostatic environment around an acidic proton or a basic lone pair. Notice that upon the addition of a proton to a substrate, such as this diamino substrate, we're adding a charge to the substrate, and that charge is positive. In deprotonating, we're taking a charge away from the substrate. When we add a positive charge to a molecule that's already positive charged, this is a rather unfavorable process. Contrast that with adding a charge to a molecule that's neutral, which is the process going on the right of this slide. That protonation event is much more favorable than the second protonation, which is taking place in a positively charged electrostatic environment. Most generally, what we can say is that the basicity of a lone pair in a positive environment is less than the basicity of a lone pair in a neutral environment. Similarly, and for similar reasons, the acidity of an XH group in the presence of a negative environment is less than the acidity of an XH group in a neutral environment. As far as these ranges are concerned, the low end of the ranges occur when the amino acid side chains are in positive environments. The high end of the pKa ranges occurs in the presence of negative environments. This is the origin of pKa modulation in enzymes. We've already seen that a number of amino acid side chains are charged at physiological pH. These are the amino acids that are going to facilitate pKa modulation, and it's one reason why you see them on the left-hand side of the graph at the beginning of this lesson. For instance, a positively charged lysine residue can attenuate the basicity of a second nearby lysine. Numerically, we would say that the pKa decreases of that lysine because it's in a positive environment. In a negative environment, the pKa of that lysine would increase and it would become more basic.